papri, and it's a very popular sweet dish in India. So let's start with the gor papri. 3½ cup whole wheat flour, 2 full cups ghee or clarified butter, jaggery 1 cup, 1½ to 2 cups dates, or according to your taste. Like if you like dates more, then you can add this is the amount, but if you don't like more dates, then you can reduce the amount. So we have a non-stick pot, and we're going to add ghee. The pot was a little bit warm already, so the ghee is going to melt. So the ghee is already melted, you can see it now. So in there, we're going to add the flour now. You don't have to make this big quantity, but in our house we need a gor papri every day, and kids also love them, so we're making in a big quantity. So we have to cook the gor papri now. It will take a bit of time to cook the gor papri. Once you add the flour in the ghee, bring down the temperature to on medium heat, and keep stirring. Almost need to cook the gor papri with just ghee and flour, almost 8 to 10 minutes. So now the color has changed a little bit, it looks like a brown color. And you can also smell when it's you know, done. So now you're going to add the jaggery, molasses, and keep stirring. Even for when you cook that 8 to 10 minutes, you continuously, you have to keep stirring. It should not get any lumps or anything in gor papri. We're going to add the date in the gor papri. You're going to add a date at last, otherwise it will get hard in the gor papri. If you make the gor papri with the whole wheat flour, it will make a mouth melted gor papri very crispy, crunchy. And instead of dates, also you can add a fried poha, like a rice crisp. But you have to fry them, and then you have to add the poha in the gor papri. That also tastes very nice. Also, the other thing, you can add sesame seeds. But since we are making with the dates, we're not adding anything to it. So whatever taste you like, you can make the gor papri with that. But if you're making gor papri with the poha, or just adding with the sesame seeds, then you might need a more jaggery. We needed less jaggery just because we had a date, and date has a sweeter taste. So the gor papri is almost done. You will smell when the gor papri is done. So now we're going to roll the gor. We're going to roll the gor papri in the thali, the big thali, Indian thali. You can use anything if you have a cake baking. You can use cake baking dish or anything you have in your kitchen. So we're going to spread the gor papri in the thali now. So later on we can make the cubes of the gor papri. Spread the gor papri and press it. If you want to press it a little bit good, then you can use the bowl like vatki. so it will press down very nicely. Press it on the edges as well. So when you have to make the pieces, it comes out very nicely. So the Gor Papri is spreaded nicely, and we have to cut them. Use the knife to cut. And make the small pieces of the cube in a cube shape. And also, it's the Gor Papri is also given to the people when the things happen like earthquake and disasters. Because this gives a lot of energy, and the date and the jaggery itself has a lot of iron. So it's very good
dates.
To eat in winter time also.
Dates.
Also dates, it's very nice and very good for your health. And do you know something that in the army, if they don't take anything but the date to eat while they are, on the border and fighting for anything, at that time they hardly get to eat something. So they usually eat the date. In date, when they eat date, it keeps them, energized.
Mm.
Also, another thing, Gandhiji, Mahatma Gandhi, he used to eat date when he was on fasting. So we're almost done with the Gor Papri and also with the cutting part. After that, when it's cool down, we will get the cubes out of the thali. So we're going to now, the Gor Papri is a little bit cool down. So now we're going to make the pieces and also I'm going to taste it. Very crispy, mouth melted, very nice. Be careful when you take out the cubes of the Gor Papri. Make sure that it does not break out too much, that it comes out in cube shape. So we have the airtight container to store the Gor Papri, and we're going to store that in there. Now if you have this kind of broken at the end, you can make kind of ball and then store that. So I'm going to take out all the cubes and I'm going to store that in a tight container. I'm gonna